He needs no introduction, but let me share with you what a lot of you may not know about him. He is an avid lover of plants and devoted to greening and beautifying urban environments. He strongly believes that trees play an equal, if not larger, role in growing urban habitats. Thank you, sir, for honoring us on this occasion. For those of you that know me, you know that I have spent decades of my professional life dedicated to landscaping and beautification of Chandigarh and Punjab. As a culmination of my formal career, I wanted to share with you and give back to my community of fellow professionals my years of experience and all my learnings, as they have an advantage, a better starting point, as they plan and develop our fast-growing communities and urban habitats. I couldn't think of a better way of doing that than writing, hence this book, Trees in Urban Habitats. When we think about planned cities in India, only two come to mind, Chandigarh and New Delhi. What that tells us is that for a country of our size and for all the developments and urbanization we are in the midst of, there is a phenomenal opportunity to create hundreds of planned cities and urban habitats. Trees are the most valuable elements for urban habitat. They enhance the beauty of cities, improve the macro and microclimate, help reduce global warming, reduce air pollution and noise, and overall improve the health, efficiency and productivity of human beings. Other landscape materials such as shrub and ground cover, they do not come close to contributing as much in improving the physical environment as the trees. The primary emphasis of my book is in four areas. First, to provide detailed descriptions about different kinds of trees that are suitable for use in urban areas. I have described several kinds of trees with elaborate details about the structure and texture of trees and their scale in relation to buildings, about the density, shape and form of tree plantation, the diversity in use of trees while avoiding mixing of too many kinds, about the use of flowering trees, about the tree plantation plans and buildings, and about the planned plantation of trees in relation to other infrastructural elements including roads and electric lines. Next, the book covers the fundamental principles that help obtain excellent results with trees in urban areas. I have created conceptual designs for developing parks and with flowering trees. I have presented designs of large, medium and small parks and explained techniques to achieve 100% success in growing trees in the city. Third, I have given detailed designs of tree planting in 11 different kinds of buildings. These can be lifted and applied as such in described setting, and thus will be a great help to architects and landscape designers broadly. Again, I have used visual representation and colored photographs to demonstrate these. All of these tree descriptions, fundamental principles, and building design are visually presented with extensive illustrations and colored photographs. Finally, I have presented a very bold, revolutionary idea of developing a planned city as a park. Parks are places where people relax, mingle with nature, become one with it. Nature in the form of trees can flow like air in every possible space in the city. Trees are the only elements that can do wonders in developing the entire city as one green mass that can take the shape of a park. This concept can be realized if all the spaces in the city are planted with trees extensively and continuously in an aesthetic manner. A planned city like Chandigarh can take the shape of a park if the entire urban environment that includes roads, buildings, open spaces, parks, and all places of living, work, recreation, and shopping are planted with trees in a thoroughly planned manner. Human artistry can achieve this objective, and if Chandigarh or one city in Punjab can succeed in doing this, it can be a model for the country and the entire world. Our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Modi recently announced 100 smart cities. I am so excited about this and hopeful that it will be an opportunity for planners and developers of those cities to apply the tree plantation concepts I have described in my book. I can say with confidence that my book contains everything that is needed for planned tree plantation. It is a useful resource for improving the environment of existing cities as well as the newly constructed urban habitat. The population in the world is exploding at an alarming speed, and therefore urbanization too has to keep pace with this. So the relevance of this book extends beyond the borders of India. The species of trees in other countries may be different, but the fundamental principles explained in this book would be applicable everywhere. I am happy to announce that my book is available in other countries, including USA, UK, France, Italy, Denmark, and Australia. Finally, I would like to take this opportunity to express thanks to my friend and co-author, Sardar Sarbjeet Singh Bagha, without whose hard work, dedication, determination, and persistence, this book could not have been published. Bagaji, it has been an honor and pleasure working with you. Last but not the least, my heartfelt thanks to my true partner and champion, my wife, Gurbinder, who has been patient and supportive in my journey, and my children, who have inspired and motivated me. I will leave you with few simple yet very profound words that are a tribute to a tree written decades ago by famous poet Shiv Kumar Batalvi. Shiv ne likhya hai, kuch rukh mainu putt lagde, kuch rukh lagde mama, kuch rukh nohan tiyan lagde, kuch rukh vang prama, kuch rukh mere babbe vankan, patar tama tama, kuch rukh mera ji karda hai kuchhar chok khadama, kuch rukh meri dadi vargi varge, churi paman kama, kuch rukh mere yara varge, chumma se gal lama, ek meri mehbooba vakan, ਮਿੱਠਾ ਅਤੇ ਦਿਖਾਵਾਂ ਇੱਕ ਰੁੱਖ ਮੇਰਾ ਜੀ ਕਰਦਾ ਹੈ ਚੁੰਮਾ ਤੇ ਮਰ ਜਾ ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ
regard and respect for him as a great champion for the cause of greening the state of Punjab. He has involved my father in most of the projects that were extremely dear to him, some of which are the landscaping of Anandpur Sahib, greening of the urban estates of Punjab, and so many more. We are indeed grateful to the Chief Minister of Punjab for sparing his valuable time and gracing this occasion. May I please request Honorable Lal Sahib to say a few words.
I've
changed the plan, ladies and gentlemen. The press always had their own way. They are the necessary events.
Most respected Sardar Hardayal Singh Ji Jauh Sahib, Sardar Sarbjit Singh Ji Mukha Sahib, I am really happy that I have come here for an excellent function. I must congratulate Jauh Sahib, Pukka Sahib that they have taken much pain and put their valuable time for this book. The subject of the book is trees and urban habitat. But it is not important only for the urban habitat. Trees are important at everywhere, every inch of the earth that needs proper tree plantation. I know Sardar Sahib since long. I think he is my oldest friend. What is your age? Just now. From the
82, sir.
82. But I'm 87. So I feel encouraged that I'm, God knows what will happen tomorrow, but I'm healthier than it. Actually, for the last many years, was everything, because I am a great lover of plants, especially horticulture. I am a farmer, and you will be glad to know that every inch of my farming land is under horticulture or tree. In some part of the land, I have grown this eucalyptus, another part, kinno, and other fruit trees. So I'm so fond of trees that wherever any state I go, my first priority is to bring some trees from there. Whether they're fruit trees or there are some bushes or some good trees. So I think I have not earlier seen any book on tree plantation. Tree plantation is not simply planting a tree, but as we rear our children, these trees should be reared properly. Every step, one has to take care of the tree. All of you sitting here, I know, must have gone to other countries. Their trees are in such a shape that not a single branch or anything is out of order. But in our country, see in the roadside, forest people are planting trees. They look that as they have got a polio disease of trees. One branch going this way, one branch going this way. So proper pruning, proper everything, proper feed, everything is required for the trees if one has to plant the tree. I must say that why we are suffering today in the whole country. Sometimes the floods come in Srinagar. What has happened in Srinagar, Uttarakhand, sometimes other places. This is all that we are fighting against the nature. If you fly over just in a plane, but you will see that all our mountains are empty. There are not much trees as they are used to. So I think one thing must every citizen of the country, whether he lives in village or in a city or wherever, at least two or three trees. If one has got three children, then he should plant three trees at least. If one, then one is sufficient. So if we make that one, we would put one tree and not only write the name of the children or even the school. Every school student or college student or university student, they should plant one tree. And a plate we fix on the tree that this plant has been planted by so-and-so in so-and-so year. So one should do maximum plant tree plantation. I think Joseph must be given maximum credit that he has advised many people, even in Chandigarh also. Even Mohali, I requested him to make the Mohali as a model city, as for landscaping and other lawns and the thing. You are lucky that you are living in Chandigarh. Chandigarh is the most beautiful city. Not as regards building and environment is concerned, it is also parks, trees. These are the best. I think the planner of this tree and the trees are concerned. Dr. Dawa, I think Dr. Dawa
many species.
He added to this tree plantation, and that is why Chandigarh is not known by its buildings, but it is known by its environment and also people. So I think Jog Sahab and his Sathi have done incredible job in this publishing this book, written this book. And it is not easy because he must have taken at least 2 or 3 years for the job.
Yes, sir, 3 years.
3 years for the job. I know what hard work he has to do. He appreciates his wife and other family members in that room. Where is your wife? Maybe I must Sorry, I have taken 3 years out many times. And I'm happy that you look very healthy. One must take exercise. Because I am 87. Every day, I exercise about 1 hour, minimum 1 hour. And about food also, I take very careful. I'm very careful of food and exercise. So, I don't want to give a lecture or a sermon to the people. You all know everything about these things. I think we should have a motto that trees should be planted in such a